Okay. Hello, everybody. Thanks for coming to this talk regarding disaster recovery management with Relax and Recover and Disaster Recovery Linux Manager. My name is Didac Oliveira. I'm one of the founders of the DRLM project, together with my friends Pau Roura and Ruben Carbonell, over there. And, well, this talk will consist in two parts. The first one is a brief introduction of the DRLM project history and DRLM itself. And then it's a workshop. I will show you how to manage your disaster recovery environment for Linux with Relax and Recover and DRLM. Okay. There are instructions on GitHub. If you want to follow them, we will not have enough time to prepare it now. But maybe if you have seen the presentation at FOSDEM site, there are the instructions there, and if you have the workshop is almost ready, I will give you 5-10 minutes to finish if you want to follow with your laptops my demonstration and here later. Okay. Well, let's start. First of all, I will. One moment. Okay, about the DRLM introduction. What is some features, the project history, how to contribute to it, and the new roadmap. Well, first of all, what is DRLM? Well, it's a disaster recovery solution. Works with Relax and Recover only. It's a central management tool for Relax and Recover. And it focuses on disaster recovery over the network without using ISO images or USB drives, just booting over the network and recovering the system. It helps the sysadmins to maintain all the required services to be ready to recover and backup a Linux system. For you, and it's the main concern of DRLM. It's the easy to use, and in order that the sysadmins can manage in an easy manner their disaster recovery environment for Linux. Okay, it's based on Relax and Recover framework. It's also written in Bash, and well, we will see how it works now. Well, DRLM used some services that are needed for Relax and Recover in order to recover the systems over the network. Okay. TFTP and DHCP are for the network boot, and DRLM takes care about the configurations and bringing up and stopping the services for you in order to maintain these configurations. Every time that you add a new DRLM client or removing it, okay? SSH is for the communication between DRLM and the clients. The HTTP service is to provide the configuration of Relax and Recover at runtime from one central location, instead of going off to each server, configuring it on each machine. You can configure it from DRLM server, and at runtime, when DRLM calls Relax and Recover to make the backup, the configuration is downloaded from the server, and after that, it's applied and run. And NFS is to export the disaster recovery image to the clients, and DRLM store service is just to be sure that after any reboot of the DRLM server, all the disaster recovery image are already available over the network to be ready to recover the system automatically with the last backup that we have on the server. Okay. Here we will show it's not shown at the top, but it's the backup process execution of DRLM. Okay. The first point is to verify the client if it's alive. It's a DRLM client itself. It's registered in database. Next, we collect the disk usage information from DRLM of the client from DRLM. And when we have the needed space, we build the disaster recovery match, and then we start a ReaR backup. When finished, we register this backup on DRLM database, and after that we enable it to be ready to recover from the last good backup. If any of these steps fail or ends with any error, if DRLM is properly configured, it could report the error to some monitoring tools automatically, and you could know if something goes wrong to be able to look at this and at it and solve the problem that has happened. And if there is any failure, after reporting the error, DRLM rolls back to the previous disaster recovery match to be ready to recover from the last good backup. Okay. After this backup process, we need to. I will show you the recovery process from the DRLM point of view. The first one is the network boot, because as I said, the focus of DRLM is to be able to recover the systems over the network. Then the kernel and initrd files are loaded. You will enter into the relax and recovery mode. And after that, with the proper network setup, with the DH client, you can get the IP address of the server that is managed by DRLM from DRLM. Okay. No matters if you have a static network configuration. DRLM gives you the IP address that was configured on it to be able to recover the system. And then just ReaR recover, and when finished, you can reboot it and get the system as it was before with the last backup. But if you are performing some type of cloning or migration or system migration, you can adjust the network configuration or the host name of the machine to restart and be able to bring the service up again. Okay. Well, the DRLM is based on relax and recover, on the relax and recover framework, and we have no GUI. Okay, no, we have no graphical user interface. These are the operations that you can do with the command line interface of DRLM. You can manage your networks, your clients, your backups, and since last version also the integrated job scheduler of DRLM in order to plan some backups from DRLM itself. Okay, you can add, remove, modify, or list your DRLM configuration, and it takes care, with simple comments, it takes care about the configuration of all required services and configurations. Now we will see some of the features that DRLM has. One of these is the integration with some standard system monitoring tools. You can report by mail using Zevix or Nagios, and also with HP OpenView, you can report to these systems, and could be extended in order to support more and more system monitoring tools like those. You just need to route some implementation in Bash in order to be able to report the errors to your preferred monitoring tool. Okay. Another interesting feature of DRLM is you have the unattended installation of relax and recover, its dependencies, and also performs a basic configuration of relax and recover. Okay. It's very useful because if a server needs to be managed by DRLM, you need to install relax and recover, its dependencies, and also perform some environment configurations in order to be able to do it. And with the unattended installation, you just need to add the client, install it, and it will be ready to backup and recover after that. Okay, you don't need to go to each relax and recover configuration, configure it, install it, etc., etc. And at this time, it supports Debian, Ubuntu, SUSE, and Red Hat distributions and some variants, CentOS, OpenSUSE, also. And well, it's a good feature to be, because the main concern of DRLM is the easy to use. It's one of the coolest features in order to have a healthy disaster recovery environment. Okay. Another feature that is new in the latest version is the integrated job scheduler. Okay. With this, you with a single command line, you can plan backups for in a daily, weekly, monthly, even yearly manner, and also planning backup for today at night, because I don't want to be on the terminal typing it and waiting for the result, and just with a single command you can maintain a scheduler of your backup jobs from DRLM. Okay. And another new feature that we have in the new version is the export and import of disaster recovery match between DRLM servers. Okay. Usually, we will have a production data center with one DRLM server maintaining all your disaster recovery environment. But maybe you have a contingency site with another DRLM server, and you want that the contingency site will be ready in case of disaster to recover those disaster recovery match on the contingency site. Well, you just need to export the image from the source DRLM server, send it to the target server, and import that. And after that, you will be ready to recover that image from the target disaster recovery Linux manager server. Okay. Well, these are some features. At the end of the presentation, that it's at FOSDEM page, you can see more features and more extended information of the presentation in the appendix. Okay, but we don't have time to say all the things today at this talk. Well, now we will talk about the project history. Just a brief explanation. The project is 3 years old. We started at 2013, at summer, and as you can see, 5 months later, we had the first stable version of DRLM. This was thanks to to relax and recover, because we used the framework and this helps us to develop it faster and on top an stable framework and a really good framework for us because it's well done, it's very well done. And after that, 1 year later, we integrated fully with Relax and Recover, with the central configuration also from DRLM server. And then last summer, we released the version 2 of DRLM with some major changes. And now we have the 2.1 version almost ready to be released. We are finishing some things at the documentation and finishing the documentation of the last version in order to be able to release the new the last version. Okay. Today at the workshop we will use the developed branch of DRLM that is quite stable to test it here with the new features. And well, I hope that next week it will be released. Okay. Well, another thing, it's an open source project, and how to contribute to it. You can use it and try it, use it. If you want, you can write code and send a pull request to our GitHub page, reporting issues if you are using it to us in order to improve and enhance the software. And share your experience also with DRLM could be a must, okay? If you are using it and you are happy with it, please share your experience with most more people in order to more and more people can use it. And well, that's all for the contribution. You can see more information in the DRLM.org site if you want. And well, the roadmap. I encourage you to come to the last talk of this dev room today in order to discuss about some future ideas of not just DRLM, also Relax and Recover and Veros, to talk about some future ideas, the roadmap of the new next version, and maybe some of your ideas could be helpful and we could implement them in the next version of the project. Okay? Well, the introduction is almost done. Now I will start the workshop in a few minutes. I don't know if somebody have the workshop prepared or have seen the workshop instructions. I will give you 10 minutes more or less in order to, if anyone could try to follow me with the workshop, could be done with their laptops. But anyway, you can download the workshop from the GitHub page and try it at home, at work, and test it and play it, because it's a background deployment that starts up some boxes to be installed with Relax and Recover from DRLM, and test and play with it if you want. Okay, at any time it will be available at GitHub, and it's pretty easy to use it and follow the instructions in order to play with DRLM and see how it works easily. Okay. Now let me have some time to prepare the workshop, and if you have any problems or any questions, I can.
Thank you. Thank you. Ara no es veu, eh?
Ja, no, aviam.
No, no, que dic que no es veu la línia de la pantalla.
Ah, no?
No, per això, que si escrius algú que està aquí no es veurà. Si pots fer-la més petita o...
Vale, ja
però, però és pel projector, eh?
Ja, ja ho sé, ja ho sé. Thank you.
Yes.
I'm ready. If anybody is preparing something, if not, I will continue with the workshop. Okay. Well, the workshop environment is not seen here, but we have three client machines. One it's a CentOS, the other one is Ubuntu, and the last one is a Debian. They will act as a DRLM clients, and we will have also two DRLM servers, one Ubuntu server and another with Debian. I want to have also a slash box, but the background box image is too huge, and we'll spend an hour or something like that. And as I will give you a try to test it here, it's one hour. It's not an option for this talk. But anyway, you could. It's in workshop instructions at GitHub with the background file. You can uncomment it and test it wherever you want to play with it. Okay. Well, the first thing we need to do the installation. There is no the installation is not covered in the workshop, because the instructions are on the DRLM documentation page. You can install it on Red Hat Enterprise Linux or CentOS, Debian, Ubuntu, and also slash 12. Since the last version, we added support for Ubuntu and slash in this last version. And the instructions can be followed here. Let me show you where it is. Okay. In the DRLM documentation, you can follow the instructions in order to install DRLM. In this workshop, we have the DRLM deployed on the DRLM servers, ready to be used for you and in order to try how it works. Okay. Well, what? Wow, not bad. The first thing we need to do when we install and configure a DRLM environment is to know our network, okay? Because DRLM manages disaster recovery over the network, and we must add our networks to DRLM in order to be able to manage all the required services to DRLM clients, okay? And well, these are here are the commands, but I will show you. That we will. I have the prepared the commands here because it's faster. Okay. In this one, we need. You must set a network name. It's could be any name. It's just for reference. The network IP address. It's network mask, the gateway, and the DRLM server's IP address in order to configure all the services. Okay. After adding. Here there are the added networks to DRLM. Okay. And when the networks are in DRLM, we are ready to start adding clients and installing them from DRLM server. Okay. Let's see this. Okay. We can add clients to DRLM with different commands. Okay. Well, the main command is that client in order to register the client to DRLM database. But Also, with the same command, you can install your client and all these the relax and recover dependencies from the from the command line, the same command line. Okay, the first client we will add will be the CentOS. We will set the upstream download package of the latest version of Relax and Recover, because the CentOS in its repos it has the version 1.17, and well, it works with DRLM, but in the latest version have more improvements and solved lots of bugs, and it's better to go to the latest versions always. Okay. And with Ubuntu, we will specify the user with admin rights in order to perform all the installation. By default, it's used, the root user is used in the first edition, but the next ones we will set the user with admin rights in order to install and add the client to the DRLM. Okay, I will show you here. Okay. Okay. Now we will add the ReaR CentOS client with its IP address. Okay. What we are seeing here. In the previous version of DRLM, we must set the MAC address, IP address, and a lot of things that now we gather from the network if the client is online and available. Okay. Now we are setting the host name of the client, because we don't have a DNS service here. But if we have our clients registered in DNS, we just need to set the IP address with the CIDR netmask number, and it will show you what it gathers, and if it's okay, you just need to confirm it, and the client, it's already in the DRLM database, and now it's starting the installation phase of the client. Okay, just confirm the SSH key, now the root password of the CentOS box, because we didn't specify the user. Okay, and now we will set the default password of DRLM user. This is the user that DRLM used to connect to each client in order to run the relax and recover backups. This this password doesn't matter, because after the installation it will be locked, and only the DRLM server will be able to connect with this user to the relax and recover servers. Okay. Well, now it's installing all dependencies. I'm configuring the CentOS box. Let me show you. Oh, yeah. It's not yet installed. Okay. Now, as we can see, the client is in the DRLM database, and if we want now ReaR, it's installed, and all the required environment settings and dependencies are installed also on this client. And we will be ready to backup and recover it after that. Okay?
Can I ask a question? Is it the package who creates the user, or is it the server who does over SSH a connection and does the add user commands?
It's the server that connects to the client and does it over the network with SSH. Okay? From the server, all the commands are sent, from SSH connection, and all the steps are being doing from the DRLM server. Okay, automatically, and well, as you can see now, we have the relax and recover install. And as you can see, the only configuration that is needed here is the if the DRLM is managed by DRLM, because the configuration is on the server side. Okay, I will show you now. Okay, this is a standard relax and recover configuration that it's in the server side, and at runtime, when the DRLM calls and relax and recover to do the backup, the configuration is downloaded and it will make the backup. You just need to maintain the configuration from one location, not on each of the servers of your network, okay?
Excuse me, is this the real password?
What?
I mean, is this the DRLM password store in plain text?
What?
On the SSH.
Yeah, it's the password of the recovery match. It's not the password of the DRLM user in the server, and it's just the password when you have the recovery match up and running in order to recover it. You will if you want to connect over SSH to the recovery match when it has the network up, you just need to set the root password is DRLM, but just at recovery time, without any system. It's not the plain password of the root user in the system itself. It's just in the recovery match. Okay, it's not the password in the system. It's just for booting and recovering the system. It's just for that. Okay. Well, I will show you also that after the client edition, all the DHCP configurations that you usually need to set up manually are done on DRLM side, and it's after doing a backup of this client, it will be ready to boot over the network and recover it from DRLM, okay? And also, as I said, it uses NFS for exporting the image, and we will exporting the store location of the mounted DRLM image when will be done, and it takes care about all these configuration files and all these services for you in order to have a healthy and maintained configuration of your needed disaster recovery services. Okay. Well, let me add the other two clients. Here, the one at the same. I said I put the host name because we don't have DNS, just the IP address and the CADR. And I said here that it will install it with the user background. Okay. Just the confirmation, the background password. The DRLM password that will be locked after, and just one moment to wait it and for it, and it will be installed also.
So for Ubuntu, the package is already in the default repositories.
Yes. In Ubuntu and Debian, there is no relax and recover package yet in the repos. It will be soon, but we have pre-configured variables in DRLM to get the correct package from upstream download page of Relax and Recover in order to install it on these boxes. Since version 1.18, if I remember, it was a problem with the dependencies with chorizo, and that was not previously in the with older Debian releases, and we forced it to use Relax and Recover version 1.18. in order to don't have any problems with the dependencies, okay? It's not the lastest, but it's almost the lastest. At this time, it's the lastest that it's working by default, okay? Well, I will add now the lastest client. Okay, here I just add this client to the database. It's on DRLM, but it's not installed yet. Okay. Now we had the three clients in DRLM database, but the Debian one it's not installed yet. I will install it with the inst client command. That is what add client by default now. Thus, if you specify that you will install it at the same time, okay? But just to know that there is another option. You can add the clients to DRLM if they are offline, and after the systems are up and configured with the network, etc., you can install them from DRLM also after, okay? Okay. Well,
can you also do some steps already at the client side? For instance, if you like use some configuration management system that you there define, I need to have these packages installed. Can you do it also in that way? So instead of I think the master server push everything or initiate all the commands, can you let the clients already do most of the work in advance?
You can do it if you want with any configuration management system. You can prepare it the clients to have all the configuration set. But if you don't have it, DRLM does it by yourself. Okay.
There are no problems with overwriting or.
No, if the packages are installed and configured, DRLM just try to install it, are already there is no problem. And also the DRLM user, if something happens with SSH, the DRLM user will be recreated because you must send the SSH key from DRLM server to the client in order to lock the password after that, but could be done many times if you want, okay? Well, now we have the three clients installed and properly configured on DRLM with our networks. Okay. And well, we will start now to plan some backups on DRLM server. Okay, it's okay. Let me adjust the times. Okay. Now we added a backup job at in 1 minute with each 5 minutes will be done, and with we'll end to try to do it to start backups again at in at 12:11. Okay, it's just the scheduler, and we can show you that the job is here, and now it's running. Okay, the backup is running. You can type DRLM run backup with the client ID or the client name at any time if you want, but the, with the scheduler, do it by yourself in a planned manner if you want to keep a monthly, weekly, or backups of your clients. Okay. Let me add another jobs here. Okay. Now we planned another backup job without end date. It will continue backing up always until we drop that job from DRLM. And the last one will be a one-shot backup. And well, we have the planned scheduled backups here. Each 5 minutes. Usually, you will use a daily, weekly, or monthly basis for repeat. But here, for testing and playing with it, we set to 5 minutes. If any of these schedules found that there is the backup of the client is trying to backup again, it's running. It just detects it and stops trying to do that backup. Okay, there will be no conflicts on that. You can have many jobs planned with the same client, and if any of or any one of them have a collision sometime, there is no problem. The first one is the correct backup, and the next execution just skips the backup if found that is already running. Okay, and well, we just planned it. We've seen that there are some jobs running here. Okay, DRLM run. Here are the three clients running backups now at this time. We don't have any backup yet finished. Okay, if we go to the clients, it's running here. Okay. I missed to show one slide previously, but it's the how the jobs are configured at DRLM, and well, already running. Okay. And well, we have here the two packets have finished, and we'll continue to be planned after that. And in few minutes, we will see that there are more backups here in DRLM. By default, DRLM only keeps at disk the last two backups of your clients. Okay, you can configure it to increase it, but you must have enough space on file system to save them. It's a good practice to each week, or you have your backups weekly or monthly. After that, to send those backup files, the disaster recovery image, to tape with standard backup tool. But the two last steps by default will be ready to recover from the DRLM server with no need to go to the tape and recover the files in order to recover your systems. Okay, because first of all, before recovering any data, you need to have an operating system running. Okay, and this is the concern of and the main target of DRLM in order to have your operating systems have a ready to recover environment. Okay.
I was not here for the previous talk because probably that was about the ReaR. Can you very shortly explain, like, is the ReaR using rsync or it creates
no.
an image?
Okay, well, let me show with. Okay. Okay, as you can see here, Relax and Recover supports different protocols and to backup your systems. By default, uses TER backup. You can also configure it to send the backups directly to BearOS or other backup tools. We use NFS and the default TAR backup in order to store the images on DRLM. Okay. These are some of the configurations that you need to do. It's well explained in Relax and Recover documentation pages, but by default this should work. If you want to exclude some file systems or just backing up the root BG of your operating system, because it's the main operating system itself, and get leave the backup data to another tools, you just need to extend the configuration on DRLM server in order to do it. Okay. Let me show that at this time we have three mounted DRLM images of each one of our clients, and inside we'll see two folders. Let me do this. Okay, we'll have the backup file of TAR compressed, and the kernel and initrd files on the PXG folder to be able to boot from over the network. Okay, and is already configured in order to boot from the network and recover the system without needs of doing anything in DRLM. Okay, let me see if there are more backups. No, not yet. Okay, there are two running. Okay, had those who planned previously in the scheduler. And now I will show you how to configure the mail error reporting in order to send the alerts by mail in that case, because it's the easy way. I experienced some problems with the internet connection previously to send outside from this network, but you can set it to configure it to send to the root mail account of the server. Okay. Let me show that The configuration is already done because I prepared previously. Alerts. Okay. This will be the configuration to send to an external mail server with my mail, and my password is in that file. I don't want to show you my personal password, but this works to send the mails. We will force to fail now a backup and show that it's sending to the root local host account now, because I configured it for that. Okay. Okay. Need DRLM run. Okay, it's running yet. This backup. Okay, with some backups enabled, by default it's enabled the last backup on the DRLM server, but if you experience any problem with the last backup, you can say to the DRLM to enable a previously good backup that was in disk, and you can try to recover from that, okay? My is here. Okay, it's still running from backups. I need to wait because the configuration was no. I have the configuration already done. I can try to force the ReaR Debian, ReaR CentOS. Okay.
This is the backup of the Debian client, or
no? It's
the CentOS.
The CentOS backup. Okay. Okay. Okay, I think I missed to configure something. DRLM. Yes, of course. I never will receive any mail because. Okay. I tried with the command line, but I didn't try it yet. Ubuntu, it's running, still running. No, it's finished. And then okay, I will.
True, false in the backup status.
Yes, it's a. We need to change it because it's a. If the backup is enabled or not, okay, it's the status of the backup, but it's not correctly explained in the output. And now I will try to stop. Well, I will try to run a. Okay, CentOS, and it's the machine. It's I think the machine is stopped yet, or if not, I will stop now. It's running. Let me stop it. The backup will fail and we will receive, if all goes okay, we will receive a mail from DRLM.
When it starts a backup, does it export the full NFS export to that machine? Or
no, it's just exporting the data, it's a store, okay? Each the directory where the backup is mounted, okay, it just the re-exported after the recovery image it's created, because we need to export it again after mounting.
I didn't pay attention to that, if the export just like exported the full data store.
No, it's exported
specific directory to that client.
So each directory is exported to each client. Okay, just it's exported the image of each client to the client. It's not a Google Direct file system open to anything. It's we take some care about security and we only export the image to the client that need it. Well. In the meantime, I will connect to the okay, we have mounted this Ubuntu backup. Okay. Okay, as we can see here, the backup I have enabled this one. Okay. And now we will enable this other one. Sorry. What? Ah, maybe the Ubuntu one is...
It's false.
No.
Status is false. Is that a problem?
I think it's because the previous backup, and now it's running Ubuntu. It's I configured the job scheduler with to continue planning jobs, but and the last the previous one was dropped, and the new one it's there. Okay, and let me check it. Yes, the CentOS is running yet, but. Or maybe I missed something in the... No, it's... False. Okay, I... Okay, I copied the wrong backup ID. Okay, now, as we can see, the backup I've enabled, it's the previous one. Okay, and we can see here that it's now enabled, and the other one it's disabled. Okay? Okay, thank you. Let me show briefly because I have no time to do. As we can see here, we at the 9. Okay, the alert that there was a problem with the backup. We received the alert by mail, and this will be the same for other monitoring tools like Nagios, Zevix, or anywhere if that are supported by DRLM. Okay. DRLM, please. I will show you how to export an image and recover it from the other server, okay? Okay. Now we are sending the exported backup to the destination DRLM server, the Debian 1. As you can see, we have already configured the networks and the client to be imported in this server. Okay.
Maybe probably I'm misunderstanding something. So when you turn off the Ubuntu image that you already back up, I was expecting to be launched automatically by the daemon of the DRLM.
Sorry,
and when you turn off the Ubuntu image, I was expecting the daemon of your tool to automatically launch the backup to deploy.
No, you can enable or disable the. It's for the backups already done. Okay, you can disable the last backup and enable a previous one. But the, it's not the. It will not start again a new backup. You can start the backup with another command, the RAM backup command. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Well,
when you do the backup, like in a normal situation, you like every day the backup. Is it incremental? Or it's
no, it's each time it's a full backup. It's a full image. Okay, we will we hope that we will support incremental something like that in the future. But at this time, it's our full backups with all the each time with each recovery match. Okay, at the time that of that backup.
You mentioned there was integration with some backup tools. What kind of integration?
Well, Relax and Recover has integration with some backup tools like Veros and others. DRLM just takes care of the management of Relax and Recover deployment. And when after you have the your images in DRLM, you can use Veros or any backup tool to send those images to the tape. But having a read image to recover from DRLM server, okay, over the network.
So there is no like integration that the client would use Barrios or something else.
No, we store the backup on the DR image because it now with we are exporting one, sending to the another DRLM server in an easy way, and after importing it, I will show you to recover from the new one, okay. It's okay, it's transferred. No, I'm importing the received backup from the other DRLM server. I will stop the previous one to be sure that here we have the same networks between the servers, and it's not a typical use case because we usually send from one side to another side with different networks and different network configurations, but in order to the PX services doesn't have conflict, we have I put it off. Now, as we can see, the client, the backup is also here and ready to recover. Okay? Now let me show you how to setting. No, not yet. Power off. Okay. We need to disable the NAT NAT device because VirtualBox only boots from the first available adapter from PXG, and set the network to boot in the machine. And well, if it's working, okay. Let me. We have the DRLM boot menu in order to, and we will start loading the kernel and inter image from the DRLM server. Okay. I hope that I could recover in time. Okay. We don't have a client. Okay, we are gathering the network from the DRLM server. Okay. Sorry. From the, we need to specify the server. Yeah, and the ID of the client. And well, it's pure relax and recover now. It's just recreating the layout and recovering now the backup image from the new DRLM server. And I think it will be ready to show you that the system was recovered okay. Okay.
When you connected to this console, to the recovery version, it didn't ask you for the password that was in the configuration.
No, the configuration is for if you have the network available in the recovery match here, you can connect over the network and run ReaR recover.
It will ask you.
Okay, it will ask for the password for over SSH. No, we don't need to change anything in the system because it's the same machine with the same network configuration. Power off. System, hard drive again, adjust the network, and it will start again with the system recovered. Okay. And that's all for the recovery. These are the slides of what we done previously, the recover slides, because I don't have time to explain it because the time is over. And some best practice that we can use with DRLM, keep the arch dir when the DR image are stored in a separate file system. With enough space, adjust the kernel loop limit to the amount of lines you want to manage. Please use it always in a dedicated server with properly date and time configured, because the scheduler if not doesn't work. Avoid using it in networks with another page service on it, because they could experience problems. And the minimum amount of RAM for DRLM should be 4 GB. For a production site with some clients managing some disaster recovery or clients for disaster recovery. Okay, and well, I don't know that if we have time for more questions or answers, but anyway, we will be here all the whole day and later in the last talk of this dev room. And well, hope that this workshop and the talk help you to know more about disaster recovery management, and I encourage you to use it and try it with the workshop at home or at work, and use it, please. And well, thank you very much for coming.
I have
it. We have time for any question.
At what scale have you seen this being run? Like how many machines have we?
We have a customer with, yes. Yes, we have a customer with using DRLM in production, and with 4 GB of RAM on DRLM server, it's managing over 100 clients easily. From it always depends of the on your throughput, network throughput, your CPU power and your memory to be able to manage more and more clients from one DRLM server. Okay.
I mentioned the 4 distributions that are supported at the moment and a couple of distributions that look like them. But a lot of servers start like Ubuntu, for example, and after a couple of years of changes everywhere, it looks more like an LFS system. How would that work? Would it still be...
I don't understand your question, sorry.
Well, a distribution that server that's no longer... Well, that started as a random distribution, a Red Hat, I don't know, but had a lot of changes. Configuration files are now in other places. A lot of software installed from source instead of packages. It's no more real Red Hat, for example. Would that work?
This is to be able to recover a system with built software from source and with different configurations. The better option is to use Relax and Recover. Because it recovers all the data and files whenever they were before the at backup time. Okay, there is no reinstallation of packages or something like that. It just recreates the layout of your system and recovers it to the system. Okay, and also for migrations between different hypervisors. As you are taking the backup inside the virtual machine, you it doesn't matter if you have a VMware or KVM. You just backup or physical server, moving to virtual or virtual to physical. It could be done because you are backing up the operating system and the layout inside the VM, and you can recover it wherever you want. Okay. Okay. Time is over. Okay, please.
Given that it's exclusively managing the PXE environment, which it doesn't sit well out of the box with sort of bare metal deployments, so are there any sort of practices for initial deployment? Can you deploy a packet to deploy a base install backup that you've taken to another client, say, that sort of thing?
Yes, you can take the backup of one of your servers and use it as a template of other servers to perform a bare metal install from DRLM. You just need to export the image and import to a new client in the same server. You could be done also, and you can recover it later. You need to adjust it. Okay. Sorry, time is over. We will be here all the whole day. If you have more questions or something, we will be pleased to ask it. Okay, to answer it. Thank you.